Hello everyone, welcome back for another Cook With Me. Today I'm making a quick immune booster. Fish soup, fish tea, fish broth, whatever you want to call it. I'm just using up stuff that I have in the freezer and in the fridge, in my pantry. And I'm making some fried fish fillets for Kevin. And of course I can't show you that. I already made everything, but of course I can't show you it because Kevin already licked it up. But coronavirus has been declared a pandemic. So everyone's going crazy, the groceries are crazy. There are a few cases in Houston right now. So everyone's going to the grocery, buying up all their Lysol and their water and toilet paper and everything else. So I decided that I was just gonna stay home today and make a quick immune boosting fish broth. So come join me in the kitchen today and see how I make this fish broth. I'm gonna make a stock first. And of course, I'm gonna fry those fish fillets for Kevin. So come join me in the kitchen. I'm just washing out the fish with some lemon. So the fish has been filleted. We got it filleted at the seafood market down in Seabrook. Kevin hates fish with bone, so see, it has no bones in it. I kept the bone to make my stock, my fish stock, fish and shrimp stock, and that's gonna go into my fish broth. So I'm just gonna let this sit here for about, I would say like 5 minutes, and then I'll rinse it out. So first I'm gonna make the fried fish for Kevin because I know he's hungry. And so I'm gonna season up the fish first. I'll season all the fish one time and then I'll take out mine for the fish broth. So here I have some seasoning blocks. These are the frozen ones that I showed you all in the last video. If you didn't see that, I'll leave the link for it in the cards above. So I'm just gonna add a little, like a little dot of water, a little drop of water, and then put it in the microwave for about 10 seconds, and then it will be defrosted. So the seasoning is all defrosted now, so I'm gonna season up those fish fillets. So to season up the fish, I'm going to keep it really basic. So I'm gonna take two of these fillets to put in my fish broth, maybe one, because I find it looks like a little bit. And I only need one little piece just to flavor my fish broth, because I'm already making that shrimp and fish bone stock, which is gonna be so nutrient dense, it's gonna be so healthy. This is a redfish and it's 38% fat. And as you know, omega-3 fatty acids from fish, they are some of the most important nutrients that we need for our brain and for our bodies. So it's always good to have to include fish in your diet, whether it's in a stock or you eat it fried fish, you make curried fish, or however you like to eat your fish. So to start off, I'm going to add some salt. I'm sorry about the shadow. I need to figure out how to get rid of that shadow. So now I'm going to add the green seasoning in. You want to make sure you add enough. This is very concentrated. You would have seen me make this in my last video. So I made a good amount and I put it in the freezer. So make sure you massage it all over the flesh and the skin and everything. Now to this, I'm gonna add a little bit of paprika. I like adding lemon pepper to fish, especially when I'm doing fried fish, but today I don't have any lemon pepper, so I'll just omit that. Ooh, okay, I didn't want so much, but a little bit of Hungarian paprika. And I'm using some of this Tony's Scotch Bonnet pepper powder. This has been amazing. I don't want to use too much. It really does have a strong kick, so I don't use too much when I'm adding it to anything. Oh, the last thing I want to add is some black pepper. So let me add that before I mix it. So now that I've added the black pepper, I'm just gonna go in and give it a good mix. Okay, so that looks good. So now that I've seasoned up the fish, I'm just gonna set it aside and let it marinate and soak up all those amazing seasonings that I added. And while this marinates, I will work on my shrimp and fish stock ingredients, as well as the fish broth ingredients. So here are all the ingredients I'm going to use in the stock. So these are the aromatics. Okay, I'm missing one thing, the onion. Actually two things I'm missing, the garlic and the onion. This always happens because I never write down my ingredients. I just go in the fridge and I just look for everything and I'm like, okay, I have everything. And then now you see I actually forget the onion and the garlic, the two most important ingredients. So these are the aromatics. I have the onion, the celery, and the carrots. These are gonna be like the mirepoix or the base of the stock. So I'm gonna add some chive or some scallion. This crazy hot pepper that burned me up last time. I have some serrano peppers. These are my substitute for pimento peppers, even though they're a little hotter. I have some thyme. Some ginger because we need all the immune boosting nutrients that we could get right now because of the whole coronavirus. As you know, garlic is a strong anti-inflammatory, it's an antioxidant, it helps to combat the flu, it has so many benefits, it helps to lower your blood pressure. So I love using a lot of garlic and I'm so happy that Kevin also loves garlic. I usually use about one and a half heads of garlic. So for this recipe I'm going to use a good amount because we want all those nutrients in the stock, and then when I make the fish broth I'm gonna add some more garlic also. So this soup or fish broth is going to be really flavorful and it's also going to be highly nutritious and an immune booster for this crazy coronavirus season that we all need to be careful of, and we need to boost our immune systems just so that we reduce our risk of catching this coronavirus. So these are the serrano chilies. They have a nice kick to it. So for the garlic, I'm not going to peel it. I want to extract whatever nutrients the skin. Yummy garlic now, I just realized I say garlic. I want to extract the nutrients from the ginger skin. So I'm just gonna chop this up into smaller pieces. Because this is actually not gonna go into the fish broth, it's just gonna flavor the stock. And lastly, I have this pepper. I'm just gonna cut this into a few pieces. Because of course, this is just gonna flavor the stock also. And I am not touching this. I respect this pepper. So I have 1.5 cups of flour here. I think that should be enough for those fillets. Some salt. And I'll use a little bit of the paprika again. And you can add whatever you want. You can actually, let me add some chili powder. Add a little bit of this chili. This is actually extra hot chili, so I won't add too much. And of course, we already seasoned the fish with green seasoning and that scotch bonnet pepper powder and the paprika, so this is just some extra flavor. So I'm gonna put the pan to heat up. I'm actually using a baking dish. This works for me. So honestly, I like to just taste it. You don't have to, this is just me because I'm crazy. So it tastes good. It has enough salt. But what I'll do is I'll fry one first and then I'll let Kevin taste it and he'll let me know what it needs. So I'm gonna fry the fish now. It marinated for about, I would say, half an hour. So I'm just gonna pick up one of the fillets. And it's gonna go into the flour. You just want to make sure both sides are coated and then you add it to the hot oil. So it's actually on medium high heat right now and this is just going to take about 4 to 6 minutes to fully cook. So here I have my ingredients for the seafood stock. So first up, these are the main ingredients, some shrimp shells. So all you do when you buy shrimp and you're cleaning it, just put the shells in a Ziploc bag and put it in the freezer and just keep stacking it up until you get a good amount. And if you have some shrimp heads, even better, because they have a lot of nutrients. I have the fish bones from that whole fish that we got. As you saw before, I fried up the fillets and I'm using the bones for the stock. So nothing is gonna go to waste. And then here I have the ingredients chopped up. I have the thyme, ginger, hot pepper, serrano peppers, some cyber scallion, the celery, carrots, onion, so this is the mirepoix. I have some tomato paste. You could use some ketchup or even some ruku. Of course, I'll use some salt and some black pepper. And I have the garlic sitting there and some lemongrass or fever grass. And if I forget anything or want to add anything while I'm cooking, which I usually do, I just like to add random ingredients when I'm cooking along the way. I'm sure most of you home cooks do the same. So you remember I showed you all how I store the herbs in the last video? This is how I store the thyme. So I wrap it in a damp paper towel. This thyme has been in the fridge for 3 weeks and it's still green and fresh. So just make sure that it's wrapped in a damp paper towel. And just make sure that it stays damp. And you just cover it up and leave it in the fridge. And the cilantro that I showed you all, that was in the fridge for about 12 days, I would say. And it was really nice and fresh yesterday when I used it. So definitely it's a good way to keep your herbs fresh and nice. I've been doing that lately and it's been working like a charm. So I have the pot on about medium heat. I'm gonna add some butter in. Make sure you add some good butter. This is some Irish butter. And I'm also adding a little bit of oil. So I'm adding in the mirepoix ingredients, which is the onion, carrots, and celery. The mirepoix is essentially the base, so it adds the flavoring for the stock. It's used a lot in French cooking. And for stock, you really don't need to use a mirepoix and saute your veggies, but I like to do it because it adds way more flavor. It adds a really nice depth of flavor to the stock. So I'm just gonna let this saute for a bit. I was just about to say chunky. But since this is a French method, I'll just say saute. So it is like chunking, where you add an aromatic so veggies to the hot oil and you saute it. So as you can see, our mirepoix is getting a little bit brown there. So I'm gonna add that fever grass in. I'll also add the garlic in. Remember I told you all I love plenty garlic, so it's gonna get a good amount of garlic. And for this recipe you can add whatever seasonings you want. You could add some peppercorn, some allspice berries, whatever herbs you like. Now I'm adding the pepper, the ginger, and the thyme. And a little squirt of tomato paste. You could cut up some tomatoes in it if you want to. Or you could add ketchup. So now I'll add the bone and the shells. Fish bones are so good for you. They have gelatin in it, which has collagen. And as you know, collagen is really good for you. It supports your joint health and it's good for your bones. So you have to incorporate collagen into your diet. Wow, the smell is incredible. I wish you all could smell this. And if you have crab shells or lobster tails, like, you know, the little end of the lobster tail or the claws that you don't use, make a stock with it. It's so healthy. And of course, if you had the shrimp heads, those are great to add also. They have a lot of nutrients. And seafood is high in iodine also, which we all need in our diet. So you can see that the shrimp shells turn pink. And it's always good to go with a good shrimp shell. Like, you don't want to get the shrimp that have been sitting there for a long time and they put preservatives in it. You know, that soapy stuff that you get when you buy shrimp. You don't want it to have that on it. And one thing I forgot to mention too, the most important thing, fish heads. If you had fish heads, they are great. Even though I don't like seeing fish heads, it is one of the best parts to put in your stock, to include in your stock. So now I'm adding some water. I think it needs more. So lastly, I'll add the seitan. This is gonna have so much flavor and it's gonna be so nutrient dense. So now right before I cover it, I'll add some black pepper. And I'll add some salt in. So I have some frozen green seasoning here, I'm gonna add it in. You could add some chopped up bandania or culantro, ricao. You could add some fresh cilantro. I used up all my fresh cilantro yesterday. But I just remembered that I actually have some frozen ones. So I will add a little bit. It's always good to have some stuff frozen. For when you have days that you don't have anything fresh, you just pull out all your frozen stuff, which is what I'm doing today. Okay, so this is finally gonna get covered and then I'll come back and show you what it looks like, because once it froths up, I like to skim off the top and then put it back to simmer. So the fish and shrimp stock has been simmering for a while, for about an hour and a half, I would say. It looks good, it smells good. And about 10 minutes into it bubbling, I actually just skimmed off some of the froth from the top, the impurities, and then I covered it and let it simmer on low heat. So that's the only thing I didn't show you. So this looks good. Can't wait to make my fish broth. Yum. So I'm gonna turn this off and I'll show you the other ingredients that I'll use for the actual fish broth or fish broth. So here are the ingredients I'll use in the actual fish broth. So I have some frozen cassava here. This has been in the freezer. I usually use this when I'm making boil and fry for Kevin, or if I'm making a soup, a stewed chicken soup. I have some whole okra here, or okra. These are frozen also. These come in really handy because sometimes I feel like eating like a okra rice or some soup and I don't have any fresh okra. So this comes in handy. Some pumpkin, well this is butternut squash, but this also comes in handy for when I'm making pilaf, when I just need a handful of squash. I usually just get these and they come in handy. And I have a few aloo here, or potatoes, and I'll use some elbow macaroni. I'm not putting dumplings in it today. You know, usually in a Trini fish broth, we use the long macaroni. So I'm just using whatever ingredients I have here at home. I couldn't go out to get any fresh ingredients. So I figured I'd just use up what I have in the freezer, the fridge, and in the pantry. So I'm just making do with what I have. So I just strain that stock. And this sadly has to go into the garbage, but it saved its purpose. We have most of the nutrients from everything we added. So I used this spider to get the big stuff out, and then I used the strainer to get the actual stock. So this is what the stock looks like. So you see how it has that orange color? That's from the seafood and of course from the carrots and from the butter. So it smells amazing, it looks amazing, and I can't wait to make my fish broth. And of course this entire bowl is not going to be used for the fish broth. If I was making for probably like 6 to 8 people, yeah, I would use all this. But I'm the only person who's going to be eating from this. Kevin doesn't really like fish broth like that. So I like to freeze it. I know I'm not going to make broth anytime soon again, well at least in the next week. So I'm not going to put it in the fridge, I'll just freeze it and it'll last for about 4 months. Some people say it lasts 6 months, I wouldn't leave it that long. So of course before you put it in the freezer, you want to make sure it comes to room temp. Don't put any hot liquids in your freezer or your fridge. Oh, and if you're going to put this in your fridge, it will last, I would say for the longest, I'll leave it 3 days. So I have an empty pot here, this is the same pot I use for the stock. So I washed it out. Now I'm gonna cook the fish broth in this, and since we already made the stock and we chunked it or sauteed the aromatics in there, we don't need to chunky this fish broth because the stock has so much flavor already. So I'm gonna put the heat on and I'm gonna add the stock right away. And I'm adding just a little bit of water just to get out whatever stock was in this measuring cup. So right away I'll go in with some of the ingredients. I'll add the cassava. And you can add whatever provisions you like to add. Remember I told you all this is not a traditional fish broth. If you want a traditional or authentic fish broth, check out my brother's fish broth. It's not entirely traditional, but that's just his take on fish broth, which is closest to how most Trinbagonians make this. So you can add some green fig also. Green fig goes so good in broth. So that went in first, and I'm gonna add the carrots. You could actually add everything at this point, but I will add the okras last. The okra and the pasta, the elbows, I'll add that in last. So this is how the squash looks. I washed it out. I washed out the okras also. And I just cut the tail and the head off. So I just realized because the squash is kind of pre-cooked already and because it's frozen and very mushy, I'll add that in with the okras. Because if I add it in now, it's just going to fall apart in the broth and I wanted to keep its shape and be chunky. So I have a few other ingredients I want to add. Some garlic, celery, and hot pepper. And I also have some cut up bird pepper or bird's eye chilies. And I have some salve here or scallion. I'll keep that for when it's nearly finished. So you can add other ground provisions like sweet potatoes, arrows, dashin, yam. I'm keeping it really basic because I'm just using what I have. And I want like a light broth. Now I'll cover it and let it come up to a rolling boil. So the fish broth is finished. I added the okras, the pumpkin, the elbows, the fish. I added some chopped celery, some sive or scallion, some chopped cilantro. So this is good enough for me. See, it has that nice thin broth. That's the stock that we made. Yum, I can't wait to eat. Hi everyone, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this little cook with me. And I hope you're staying safe with this whole coronavirus outbreak. Make sure you're educating yourself and you're watching the news and you're taking all the precautionary measures to keep yourself out of harm. So thank you again for watching, and if you like the video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. Comment below, leave me all your questions, your suggestions, your thoughts and everything else. I love hearing from you all. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't already and hit that bell so you'll be notified of all the new videos. Thank you so much again. I'll see you all next time. Bye. Just hit these spots earlier. And you know, when you're eating a broth, it has to be nice and peppery. This has that nice peppery kick to it. So good. So this can be considered a fish tea, a fish soup, or a fish broth, as we call it back in Trinidad and Tobago. It's a great rehydrator, a great immune booster. People love to drink fish broth when they have a hangover, so after a night of drinking or partying, they love fish broth because it has all those nutrients in it. As I mentioned before, the fish is high in omega-3 fatty acids. The garlic is a great anti-inflammatory, it's a great antioxidant. There are so many benefits. It's just so good for your soul. It's so tasty, so nutrient rich, and you're definitely gonna love it if you haven't tried it already. So I hope you all make some of this delicious fish broth soon.